Hi, I'm Charlie Hodgson. I'm here to celebrate Nordoff Robbins.
Charlie, it's an honour to have you with us tonight in every sense of that word. Can you talk about why Nordoff Robbins as a charity and the work it does is so vitally important to support and get behind?
Well, from first-hand experience of going to the therapy centre, you could see the effect that it had on people, with mental illness, mental needs, and it was inspiring to see what the therapists actually did with the children that were working with them at the time. It was incredible to see the effect that had on them. So you can certainly see the power of music. You can certainly see why it works, and to be supporting a charity such as this is amazing.
And what does it mean for you personally, not just to be attending tonight, but to be our guest of honour and being celebrated yourself for your astonishing career achievement?
It's incredible. When I had the call last year from the guys at VU, it was completely out of the blue. I wasn't expecting it. My career had finished, and certainly I thought things like this reserved for those that have testimony of years and all that sort of stuff. So to be here now, to be the honour player, is pretty special. I'm most proud of. The longevity, maybe. I think with the way the game is and how physical it's become, and to overcome injury, to overcome adversity, I suppose, and to show my resilience, I think that's the one thing I'm most proud of. I'm obviously very proud of achievements of winning trophies and that, but to have lasted as long as I have, I'm very, very proud of that.
Of course, we're rapidly approaching the Six Nations. What for you makes it unique as a sporting experience?
I suppose being English, the fact that everybody else hates the English. It's very true. Playing in it was a special time, whether you're playing at Twickenham, whether you're going away to the grounds. Just something that that gets everybody excited, gets everybody involved, and I'm really looking forward to it. It's great to be a fan watching in and seeing the progress of all the teams, really, and seeing what's going to happen in the next few weeks.
I mean, talking about England, obviously agonisingly close to the Grand Slam last time. How proud are you of the work that the team's been doing, and what do you think of particularly Eddie? Because I think obviously he's largely been seen to have a very positive effect, particularly on consistency, since he's come in.
He has, yeah. He's certainly taken the team to the next level, hasn't he? Stuart Lancaster and Eddie will, I think, admit this, that Stuart put in the good foundations for the team, but Eddie's taken it on to the next level, and the consistency the boys are showing is amazing, really. And certainly performances in the autumn were great, and obviously they'll be wanting to take that... take a positivity through to the Six Nations.
I'm Richard Wigglesworth.
Richard, it's fantastic to have you here tonight. What makes tonight such a very special, important night, supporting this charity and celebrating Charlie next to you?
Well, I think it's a big event on the rugby calendar now, us getting together for this Nordoff Robbins dinner. Every year it blows you away with all the help they give all these people, and brilliant to be part of it, and extra special that it's one of my very good friends, Charlie Hodgson's testimonial do, and celebrating his fantastic career, and be a great night all round.
Of course, excitement for the Six Nations starting to reach fever pitch now. What makes the Six Nations unique as a sporting experience, and what are you most excited for this season?
I think, like anything, it's got important. It's got a massive amount of tradition, all that history that goes with it. So many great games and championships down the year. I think England are the team to beat again. They look really strong. Obviously had a couple of injuries recently, but strength in depth is there, and I'm backing them to win it again.
And what do you think about the work that Eddie Jones has done since coming on board? Because I think the fans have been, I think, delighted to see that consistency finally there.
Well, I think consistency is the word. He's lost one game in 2.5 years, something that's a pretty impressive record. So he's obviously brought a huge amount to it. The lads have bought into what he's doing, and the simple things England do really, really well. Got a great set piece and great defence, and they're improving all the time. All the signs are there.
Of course, every time we have the Six Nations, it inevitably leads to a discussion about that North-Southern Hemisphere divide. Where do you think we are on that spectrum at the moment? Because I think there's a real sense that after last year, England were really at a point where there really wasn't much to choose between North and South.
Well, I don't think there is a divide. I think that's gone. I think we had to take it on the chin that there was last World Cup, but there's no divide now. I think New Zealand are the number one team in the world, but England are number two, so and Ireland are a top team, so I don't see any divide.
Of course, looking forward to the championship, people are excited about the teams, but we're also excited about individual players. Are there any individuals in particular that you think are really primed to have a big championship at the Six Nations?
I'm always biased towards the Saracens players, but Owen Farrell's incredibly important to what England do, as is Maro Itoje. I think Maro's had a little 4-week break with a broken jaw, and looks ready to explode. So I think those two fellas will have a big championship.
Eric Peters, I used to play for Bath in Scotland back in the 90s, and very pleased to be here. It's a great children's charity, and I think when you watch the video this evening, where they sort of show an example of what Nordoff Robbins do, if you've got children, who are able or whatever, it does almost bring a tear to your eye. So you know, it's great work that they do, and really good to be supportive of it.
Of course, tonight we're also celebrating one of the true icons of the sport in Charlie. What makes him such an inspirational and important figure for rugby fans?
Well, I mean, as you say, he's obviously played for an awful long time. He was sort of coming, I think, to the fore as I was playing, and obviously had a long career afterwards. But he played, you know, tremendously well throughout his time, being very consistent, model professional, and obviously someone young players now look up to.
What do you think makes the Six Nations unique amongst sporting competitions?
Well, I think the fact that it's so well supported, you know, home advantage is such a great thing, but it's always a pleasure to go and visit one of the other big cities. So, yeah, the great passion, everyone likes to rub shoulders at work, and, you know, there's great camaraderie and great rivalry between the players and I guess their supporters. But much nicer than football in terms of how the fans get on and have a beer afterwards. So all good fun.
What do you think of the current state of the England team, particularly? I mean, I think Eddie Jones has obviously been a huge success since he's come on board.
Yeah, I think he's brought consistency, he's brought belief. He's you know, he's very good at giving them that belief to go out and produce a result. I think of late they've maybe been criticised a little bit by not playing as attractive rugby, but I think it's going to be a great Six Nations. I think the Irish are looking good, the Scots are looking good, and the Welsh are. I think haven't seen so much of the French, and I think they're sort of in a rebuilding phase at the moment. But the French in Paris can be very formidable. So I don't think any game is going to be easy. I think obviously I haven't mentioned the Italians, but on their day the Italians can produce a result. So yeah, everyone's got to be on their mettle. It may well be another one of those years where you don't win every game.
Why is Nordoff Robbins and the work the charity does so special and important?
Well, they do fantastic work with the special needs kids. Their music therapy is, you know, well renowned. I'm sort of familiar with it over the last 20 years or so with Victor and these dinners, and they've been a really amazing sort of charity to assist throughout the years.
Tonight we're getting excited for the Six Nations and also celebrating one of the icons of rugby in Charlie. What makes him for you such a very special player, so deserving of recognition here tonight?
I think, you know, his dedication to the sport. He's a really, you know, he's a great character throughout the rugby world. Everyone, you know, I know, always says what a great bloke he is. His performances have been fantastic for you know, the teams he's played for, and generally just looking forward to hoping to raise some money for him and the charity, which and obviously looking forward to seeing a few old friends and from the rugby fraternity tonight.
Of all the great contests in sport, what do you think makes the Six Nations such a unique experience for fans and for competitors?
Ooh, well, I think probably the closeness of the almost local derby situation, obviously the Six Nations manages to sort of quell up all those historical sort of hatreds against the close foes and allies. But so, I mean, I think, you know, that in itself, the team really does, you know, bring out all the real sort of best in the players. Looking forward to watching Scotland play and Ireland and France and all the rest, and see how England are going to be able to perform, because they're going to have a tough time up in Scotland, that's for sure. I think we're lucky to have Ireland at home down at Twickenham. So it's going to be a tough Six Nations for England, because we've had our share of injuries as you will get in the game, but looking forward to see how we're all going to perform, and it should be a fantastic Six Nations, I think, you know.
Talking about getting the best out of the players, what's your assessment of Eddie Jones? Because I think consistency, I mean, you can't fault his record after 2 years.
Absolutely not. Yeah, and I was delighted when I heard he was he had been you know, employed by Ian Ritchie. I mean, it was a fantastic move by him to go and go and get him and secure his services, because you know he immediately made a difference even without sort of lifting a finger, because you know it's really from my perspective, it was the mental side that he brought to it immediately, as well as obviously the organisation and skills that he's produced. But he was also able to sort of take away the fact that he's not English, and that almost sort of would have been a bit of a backbreaker for a lot of English coaches over the years, simply because I suppose everyone loves to hate England, it seems, you know, as Eddie told all the players, you know, everyone thinks the English are terrible people, and they raise their game to play against us. So he manages to deflect a lot of that in his off-field press conferences, the mind games he plays, and then instill in the players some amazing confidence to allow themselves to go out and express themselves on the pitch. I mean, you know, seeing Japan beat South Africa when he was in charge of them, you thought, yeah, well, this guy's got something special, and sure enough, yeah, absolutely he has. So, yeah, absolutely delighted to see him well, and hope it continues for a long time. So,
I guess my final question, obviously you talk about the strength of Scotland, Ireland and England at the moment. Do you think that long accepted Northern and Southern Hemisphere gap has been obliterated now? Because there's a real sense, I think, when you look at some of the results, that maybe that doesn't exist in the way it once did.
Yeah, well, you know, you've got New Zealand potentially still top of the tree. They're still an amazing rugby nation. You've got South Africa have gone down backwards. They're going to take a lot of time to get back up, if they ever will. Australia have been hitting the skids for quite some time. So yeah, I mean, you know, Six Nations, we've sort of tend to get our act together now. The Scotland's have performed outstandingly, beating, you know, the draw with New Zealand and Ireland beating New Zealand in Chicago. And so yeah, I mean, I think we've managed somehow to bring ourselves back up. Even though if you look at the world rankings, I'm not sure we're quite up there. I haven't even looked at them recently, but. Certainly, yeah, we've managed to sort of perform and compete with the Southern Hemisphere much better than we have done in the past.
My name's Dave Hilton. It's just a fantastic course. I mean, I've been coming to these dinners for about 15 years now, and I just find it's absolutely brilliant. I can't believe the support it always gets every year, and it does such good work.
And of course, we're also honouring one of the true icons of the sport here tonight with Charlie. What for you makes him such an exemplary role model for this wonderful sport?
Well, from a very lowly prop in the game, he was always way too intelligent for me to ever catch him. He dictated the game really well. You know, he was just a very intelligent rugby player.
And of course, excitement for the Six Nations is rising by the day at the moment. What are you most looking forward to about this year's championship?
Well, hopefully a Scottish win. That'd be a good one. But no, just looking to see the performances. This year, above all others, it's going to be so exciting because there's so many nations that could win it.
Do you think that the result against New Zealand is a statement of intent, both for Scotland and for Ireland this year?
Yeah, massively. You're right. It is full intent.
What do you think is unique about the Six Nations as a sporting experience, both for fans and those taking part?
Yeah, I'm not sure. I don't know about fans, because when I first played rugby, I'm not sure I knew what rugby was and stuff like that, so I wasn't really a big supporter. But playing it just means everything. You know, it's the one big cup for the Northern Hemisphere. If you're the best Northern Hemisphere player, you want to win and walk away with that cup. It's like a mini World Cup, basically. And, you know, forget your friend is in the autumn test. You know, this means so much to every player that plays in it.
I'm Martin Afire.
Martin, fantastic to have you here tonight. I guess the obvious question, why is this charity and the work they do so important to rally behind?
It's very important, using the music to improve the lives of children. Victor, who puts this dinner on, is an old friend of mine. We played together many, many moons ago before I even ever thought about playing rugby league. And, I come out to support Nordoff Robbins and Victor.
Of course, we're also honouring one of the icons of rugby tonight with Charlie. What makes him such an iconic figure for the sport?
He's been a great player. I think his longevity, great servant for Sale, Saracens and England. You know, scored an obscene number of points, I remember, on his debut for England. I was fortunate enough to be involved in a 12-hour cyclothon with him, one of Victor's events at the back end of last year, and he's still in phenomenal shape. And, you know, looking forward to catching up tonight and, you know, hopes he has a fantastic night.
Of course, tonight also celebrating the excitement that is now very much building for this year's Six Nations. What are you most looking forward to? What makes the Six Nations such a special event for rugby fans?
I think the history, you know, it's built into, you know, the Six Nations now. And, yeah, obviously England, you know, building towards 2019. It'll be interesting to see what Eddie Jones does, especially with his back three. You know, being a winger, I'm very interested in those positions. So, yeah, it's exciting. You know, England are, you know, up there in the world rankings. And, yeah, you know, they had a pretty good autumn. And, you know, so we're going to see how they fare, you know, in 2018.
What makes the work of this charity such a very special cause to rally behind?
Yeah, I mean, there's a few things. Just beyond music, it's amazing to be part of that. I think it's a great way to help people outside as well. And just being part of Charlie Archin as well, it's an amazing person and rugby player. So just being part of that, it makes me humble.
I mean, obviously tonight we're celebrating one of the true icons of the modern game with Charlie. Why for you is he such an important role model, particularly for younger players?
Yeah, I mean, he's been around the block for ages, playing amazing rugby. And just the person who he is, I think that's probably the most important thing, is the guy behind rugby. A great family man, and just a great chat to. If you have any troubles in your life, he's a great guy to go to. And yeah, apart from the rugby, he's just an amazing person.
Of course, we're also celebrating the approaching Six Nations. As a rugby fan, how exciting is the Six Nations? What is unique about it as a spectacle?
Yeah, well, I'm definitely going to support my second team, and it'll probably be England, or it is England. As a South African joining an English club, I'll definitely support England. And yeah, it's a massive, massive Six Nations ahead. I think it's going to be a good one. But yeah, definitely backing England. Hopefully they can just win it again.
Talking about your first nation team, obviously I think there's a sense from fans that it's a bit of a rebuilding period for South Africa at the moment. Are you positive about the future of that?
Yeah, I think they've got a good structure at the moment with the new coach, with Rossie Rasmus getting in there. I think he's definitely going to change a few things. Yeah, so hopefully it gets back to where it was, but I believe it will.
I mean, what would for you be the main things you'd like to see the new coach changing? Because obviously, I mean, if you look at Eddie and the way in which he's improve the consistency for England, coaches really can have that transformative effect on the team.
Yeah, the biggest thing is I just want him to rebuild the culture of the Springboks, to be honest. I think that's what they're lacking at the moment, and hopefully with him there, they can definitely change the culture and just start winning again, I guess.
Dom, it's fantastic to have you here tonight. Why is this such an important charity to be supporting?
Oh, it's massive to support Charlie. Charlie Hodgson invited me down today, so it's great to be here and supporting him and the charity, Nordoff Robbins Charity.
Of course, we're also celebrating the excitement ahead of the Six Nations. What makes it such a very special championship?
Oh, it's amazing. I've watched it growing up my whole life, and every year it doesn't disappoint, and the rugby gets better and better every year.
How do you feel about England's chances this year? I mean, particularly I think with Eddie Jones, the consistency of the side, there's a real optimism that they might be the first side to retain it 3 years in a row this time.
I think so. I think we've got a big chance. I'm sure the boys I play with at Saris, they all say there's a good chance of us retaining it, so hopefully.
Looking to the future, what are you most excited about yourself at the moment? I mean, obviously Saracens always riding high. What are your ambitions looking to the future?
Just want to go as far as possible in my rugby career. Obviously, England would be amazing, but if not, to go my whole career with Saracens would be unbelievable, so hopefully.
Ben Ransom, I play rugby at London Irish.
Ben, it's fantastic to have you here tonight. Why is this such an important cause to be supporting?
I think just giving support to Charlie Hodgson, really, a guy that I played with many times at Saracens before. Now he's sort of involved at London Irish, so I think just giving support to him personally and also to the Nordoff charity as a whole.
And obviously Charlie is such an icon of the sport, the longevity of his career, the records he's broken. What for you makes him such a great role model for younger players?
I think just learning how he sort of trains and prepares for game when I was at Saracens, in terms of the amount of practice he puts in, not only during training but after training. The way he helps out with the young guys when I was at Saracens, I think it's just a credit to him.
Of all the great sporting contests, what do you think is unique about the Six Nations?
Oh, I just think the atmospheres they build at stadiums, like obviously like Twickenham and up at Murrayfield, I think there's just a special vibe when it comes to Six Nations that you don't really get in the domestic competitions. I think also the quality of rugby, I think it steps up as well when the Six Nations comes on. I think definitely when you compare England against the Northern Hemisphere side, they've definitely been a sort of step above in quality, and I think they're going to carry that into the Six Nations. Obviously, Eddie will be pretty pleased with his contract extension today, so I think the lads will be on a high and they'll be looking to push for that third one.
And I mean, talking about the North-South divide, do you think the results for Ireland and Scotland against New Zealand show that that gap is, if anything, non-existent now?
To an extent, yeah. I think it's showing that New Zealand of the past was sort of unbeatable, but I think now, as teams are starting to beat them, the gap is definitely closing and it's leaving room for, like you say, Ireland and Wales to sort of, and England to sort of kick on and try and get them off that number one spot.
Of course, talking about London Irish, looking to the future, what are the targets that you guys are setting for this year and beyond?
Well, obviously, we're not in a great position at the moment, bottom of the table, but we're obviously taking each game at a time and we need to step up as a squad, really, and make sure we get that next win. I think the next three Premiership games are going to be a real challenge and defining moment of the season, really, because if we need to win them, basically.
Obviously, you guys are having a tough season, but I think the fan enthusiasm, both for London Irish and for the Premiership in general, has never been at a better place. Why do you think there has been that explosion of enthusiasm for the sport in recent years?
Yeah, I think definitely at Irish have obviously got that history of doing well in competitions. And I definitely think that is sort of carried on to the domestic season at the moment. And we can definitely feel it when you're playing at home at the Majeski. Obviously, we're trying to move back to London, which I think will be better for the club. And hopefully the fan base will improve if we do move back. But I think it's just the general enthusiasm around the game at the moment.
My name's Theo Brophy-Clews. I'm a rugby player for London Irish Rugby Club.
It's fantastic to have you here tonight. Why is it so important to support this cause and to honour an icon like Charlie?
I think music therapy is a cause that's overlooked, really, and I think it's really can be really helpful. I think music means a lot of things to a lot of people, especially who are in need. So it's amazing to be here tonight, and then Charlie as well. I've only met him recently, but he's an amazing man. He's a legend of the game, so I'm really excited to hear some good stories about him. Have a good time tonight.
And obviously, it's a tough season at the moment for London Irish. The next three games, I think, really feel like they're going to be crucial. Are you energised? Is the team geared up to get the results it needs?
Definitely, you're right. It's a big three games in the Aviva Prem. So we had a good result against the Russian team Krasnoyar the other night. So that's really good. So we need to build momentum going forward. So that's the main thing over the two next LV games as well, to build some good momentum going into the Premiership games.
Why do you think this season there has been that difficulty in replicating the European form in the domestic Premiership?
I think obviously last year coming from the Championship, we get used to a certain standard of rugby. Obviously, we're trying to pride ourselves on being better than the competition last year. But the game evolves so quickly, and having a year out of the Premiership makes it hard to adjust. So we're constantly trying to adjust things in our game, and I feel we are getting there. It's a slow process, and hopefully it comes through at the end of the season.
How excited are you about the approaching Six Nations? Obviously a wonderful spectacle for a rugby fan.
Oh, it's brilliant. I mean, having people at the club who are going to be maybe involved in it, and just the whole the hype up of it and everything, is brilliant to watch. And England are always going to be amazing. So I'm really looking forward to see how the boys get on.
What is so important about the work that this charity does and celebrating a figure like Charlie as well at the same time?
Yeah, it's two great people combined. You know, the charity's amazing. I've been to the dinner for a few years, and to see the work they do with kids is amazing. So obviously a great beneficiary in Charlie Hodgson as well, someone who's given an awful lot to the game. One of the most naturally gifted players I've ever had the pleasure of playing with and against. And he's beaten me many times in different shirts, and a great person to deserve what's happening tonight.
Of course, tonight also celebrating the fever pitch excitement ahead of this year's Six Nations. Can you describe your feelings as we approach the championship?
Yeah, we can't wait to get started. It's the best tournament in the world to be involved in, and anyone could beat anyone on the day, which is the beauty of the tournament. So we'll go to Italy first, hopefully have a good game and see what happens from there.
I think obviously with England, there's been a sense that Eddie coming on board, the transformation of the consistency has delighted fans. Can you talk a little bit about the changes you think he's made in shepherding England towards that?
Yeah, he's been brilliant. Obviously, won 22 out of 23 games. He's not a bad record. He certainly knows what he's doing. He gets the best out of the players, and it's probably instilled a massive belief and confidence in the players. Then we go out there and express ourselves.
Of course, last time so agonisingly close to that Grand Slam. Is that the target this year to make up for that?
Oh, we want to win the Six Nations again. I think I'm not going to shy away from saying that. It's no team's ever done it 3 years in a row. It'd be brilliant if we could. But all starts with that first game, and then we see how we go from there.
I mean, obviously, people talk about the main obstacles to an England championship. Who for you is the big one to beat? Because I think, obviously, Ireland and Scotland both showing a lot of strength this year.
Oh, everybody wants to beat England, so every game you play against them, teams want to knock you off. So all we focus on is that first game away in Italy and hopefully get off to a good start and then crack on from there.